today I have a current makeup favorites video for you. I'm not going to call it a monthly one because I never ever ever do monthly favorites videos because I don't have enough products each month that I like love. These are just ones that I tend to reach for that I found work better than most other products that are similar and that are pretty affordable. Well, most of them are anyway. So first I'll start off with the lipsticks that I'm wearing. The first one is the base color, which is Inox's matte lipstick in nude. So it literally makes my lips like completely white. I bought it to mix with lipsticks to make them lighter. I would never wear this on its own. And the actual color that I'm wearing is Chi Chi Viva La Diva lipstick in Blonde Ambition. So it's like a fluoro pinky color. It's pretty much the same color as my top when it's mixed with a lighter lipstick. So that's what I do all the time because it is a nice color on its own, but I just feel that pastels tend to suit me more, especially because I wear very pastel coral colours, so I always love to make sure that my lipsticks match my clothing. Next is this sports girl lipstick called Pout About It Lip Colour in Fruit Tingle. It is a matte lipstick. It is very, very similar to the Chi Chi one. I wore this lipstick, this sports girl one, out shopping one day, and I had like 3 random people ask me what lipstick I was wearing, so that's always always a good sign. But yeah, it's just another kind of bright corally colour. I do tend to mix this one as well with a lighter base, but I wear it on its own as well. And this one was really cheap, it was $10, so yay! This one is the OCC Obsessive Compulsive Cosmetics Lip Tar in Cha Cha. Yeah, it's amazing. It's like literally 100% pigment. It's just, that's crazy. I got this one from CameraReadyCosmetics.com and I think it was $14 or $15. I have another one and I bought another 2, so quite fond of those. Just a little tip, definitely apply these with a lip brush because yeah, you just definitely need one because they're so pigmented. Next are these Essence lip liners. Now these I bought the red one first just because it was cheap and I wanted a red lip liner, and then I actually tried it out and like realized how amazing it was. It's so soft, so creamy, so pigmented. It isn't, you don't have to kind of pull your lips to get the color out. It's really, really easy to use, and I think it was like $2, so that's awesome. I bought Femme Fatale Cute Pink and Red Blush, so basically like a normal red color, a medium kind of plummy color, and a darker red. Definitely, if you're on a budget, or even if you aren't on a budget, but you just want to try out a different brand that's good quality, definitely try out the Essence ones. Moving on to one brush, this is the Sigma Small Angle E65. I used to use a manicure brush for my brows. I use this for my brows, but just randomly I decided to try this one and I am in love with it. It's much more sturdy than my manicure one. It's much smaller, which I thought would be kind of hard to use, but it's actually really, really easy to use. And I just love it. It's super soft. None of the bristles have ever kind of frayed out. Yeah, what can I say? It's awesome. And obviously if it's a small angled brush, you can use it for eyeliner. You can use it for just eyeshadow lining underneath and around your eyes. I love brushes that can be used for lots of things, and this is definitely one of those. Following on with the brows theme, I have the Essence Lash and Brow Gel Mascara. This is used for my brows. It's kind of getting a little bit muddy and dirty, but yeah, it just does what it's meant to do. It just sets my brows in place, especially with my new middle part. These bits of hair here are always sitting on my eyebrows, so it kind of can move them around a little bit, like the hairs in my eyebrows, and this keeps them in place, so yep, easy. Another Essence product, which is the bomb, is Essence Gel Eyeliner. A few of you guys had mentioned to me or had suggested that I, you know, try this one out, but I've already got a few gel liners, so I didn't really think I needed another one, but it was like $5 or $6, so can't go wrong with that price. This one is just in black. It's called 01 Midnight in Paris, which is a really cute name. Yep, straightforward. It's just amazing. My Maybelline gel, iStudio gel liner, whatever it's called, dried up really fast. This is just amazing. It's like thin, thin, creamy amazingness. It's pure black. It's so easy to work with. Yeah, I just can't rave enough about it. It's the best one I found so far, and it's so cheap. And yes, it does stay on all day. I wore it out once and no smudges, nothing at all. Pure brilliance. Definitely check this out. It's not, you know, expensive, so there's no excuse. Next is another Essence product. So it's the Essence Stay All Day Long Lasting Eyeshadow in 06 Rock Chick. So it's just like a metallic dark grey. I wore this on a whim. I wasn't sure if it was on a crease or not because it doesn't say that it's creaseless, and cream eyeshadows can be notorious in terms of how badly they crease. I wore this, and obviously when you wear dark eyeshadows, the chances of it creasing and being obvious that it's creased is like 10 times more than any other kind of colour. So I wore it on a whim and didn't crease once throughout the whole day, so that's just awesome. I have two other colours, and they're equally as amazing. Voice is breaking. But yeah, another product to check out if you're looking to try some cream eyeshadows or you need a dark base with a bit of shimmer in it for like a really nice smoky eye, definitely try this one out. Our last eye product is this L'Oreal, I'm just gonna call it that even though it's pronounced L'Oreal, Paris Color Infallible I don't know what the thing is, but it's Infallible Iridescent Finish Pressed Pigment in 027 Gold Mine. This is amazing as an inner corner highlight. It is amazing as an eyeshadow. It is just amazing. I will be definitely checking out other colours in this particular range, so yeah. Next is a MAC product, Mineralize Skin Finish in Light Scapade. So this I use as a highlight, get my hair out of the way, in this area here. You might be able to see it in light, I'm not too sure, but yeah, kind of like a natural, less dramatic, but just subtle highlight. And that's why I like it, I think. So yep, I use this pretty much every single day, and it's good because it's like a white highlight, so it suits any blushes, anything that you choose to wear on your face, pretty much. Next is a blush. Now this one is from The Balm. This is the Shadow Blush in Frat Boy. And this is a really nice, soft, pinky, slightly peachy blush. And it's huge. Huge. It'll last you forever. I'm wearing it today. I seem to wear it with most outfits that I choose to wear. Just because it's like, it's not too pink, but it's not too peach, it's not too coral. It's just a really nice in-between shade that, yeah, tends to suit pretty much all of the clothes or outfits or makeup styles or lipstick colours, whatever, that I tend to wear. So I really, really like that one. I like the little thing that says, so many men, so little time. That's cute. And it's cute packaging as well. It kind of reminds me of Benefits packaging. Another Balm product that I bought in the same sale is this Nude Tude palette. I love this. I use it more than my Naked palette recently. It's got this gold color that I love. It's got Sultry, this medium brown shade, matte brown shade that I use all the time as a crease color. It's got Seductive, which is a really nice brown shimmery shade. Sleek, which is like a really dark brown, which is really good for kind of defining the crease, or the outer V, sorry. And then a pure black, which is great because I only have the Naked One palette, so I don't have a pure black in any palettes. And a nice white light shade as well. So I've been using this all the time, mainly that Sultry colour because I love the tone of it, the shade. And it's really, really pigmented. It's really, really soft and easy to blend. Yeah. The next product I'm going to show you isn't to makeup. It is Fake Tan, but holy lord, this Fake Tan is absolutely amazing. In Australia, I bought this one for $13 or $12 or $14. Around there, which is pretty cheap for Fake Tan anyway. And that's including shipping. And I bought this off eBay. I'm not sure if I just said that. It's a St. Moritz or Moritz or whatever, however you pronounce it, instant self-tanning mousse in dark. and it's, oops, it's leaking out. And when it says dark, it means dark. Like, I'm wearing it today. This is the second day that I've applied it, so it hasn't really faded or anything, but it is just amazing. And the main thing with this is that you have to work really fast. Don't kind of apply it, just smudge it on and then, do something and then come back and try and blend it out. Literally, you have like 5 seconds working time with it. I found that if I don't go all the way around my arms, like really, really fast, like checking the mirror that I've got in all areas, then I'm left with lines. I'm definitely gonna be buying billions, billions, billions more of these. I am naturally white as snow, as most of you guys know, and I like to go really, really dark brown, but if you are naturally really, really pale and you haven't started off with fake tans, you haven't used fake tans before, definitely start off with, I think that there's a medium shade or a light shade. Don't go straight to the dark is really dark. dark. And also the texture of this is amazing. It's mousse, but it feels like souffle or something like that. You put it on and it's like, my other mousses are really just thin and watery. This feels creamy and just luxurious and lovely. I love this. Those of you living in the UK, you're very lucky that you can get this for so cheap. So that's it. Thank you for watching this far into the video and I will see you in about a week's time. Bye. First, I will start off with the lips. I think I'm just gonna start off. Next is another. Hello. Oh god. Hi everyone. Today's makeup video. Oh, it's a makeup video. Hi everyone. Today's. That's the weirdest meh. Today's. Hey everyone. Today I have a currently makeup favorites. Good start to the video. It doesn't even make sense what I say. What? Oh god, what am I even talking about these days? I don't even know. Hey everyone, today I have a currently... Oh my